If you shake my tree little hard, a story might drop. So y'all draw near and listen up. The Test. Pookie and Barabi wanted to grow up to be smart, smart, and have them big time job, just like, you know, children out there. So they just like everyone else had to go to school every day. Now Pookie didn't mind because he was a smart one. But Barabi, he was a different story. He didn't like school at all. So he used to cry like a baby every day as they walked the 2 mile journey to school. But Pookie and Barabi went to the Miller's Creek All-Age School. Their teacher's name was Miss Green, but they used to call her Miss Mean because she was very, very strict. Just the sight of her caused all the children to be frightened out of their minds because they knew they couldn't get away with doing any foolishness. She weighed about 300 pounds and wore thick glasses. She would always have a long stick in her hand, and when she spoke, it's as if the entire room shook with the strength of her voice. Well, it was almost time for the end of year exams, and if you didn't pass, you would not be allowed to leave school. But Pookie didn't mind because he was smart, and he knew he would get all of the questions on the test correct. But Robbie, on the other hand, was terrified because he knew he would get everything wrong. You see, all he ever did in class was look out of the window or sleep when he should have been paying attention to what Miss Green was saying. Now, but Robbie didn't want to get left behind because Pookie was his best friend. He couldn't imagine not being in class with him or playing at lunchtime together or even ducking school together. But instead of asking Pookie to help him study, Barabi decided to ask Pookie to help him cheat on the test. Barabi came up with this wonderful plan to sit right on the side of Pookie and to look at his answers every time Miss Green wasn't paying attention. Barabi felt that his plan was foolproof, and Pookie liked the plan too, only because it was yet another opportunity for him to play a trick on Barabi. So Pookie told his friend that he would agree to help him if he did 3 things for him. But Barabi, of course, agreed because nothing was more important than passing the test. The first thing Barabi had to do was iron all of Pookie's school clothes for a week. So he was forced to get up at 3 in the morning and sweat while ironing all of those rough, dry clothes that were stacked in a pile that almost reached the roof. When Pookie came to pick up his clothes, Barabi said, "You sure you can help me get an A on the test, right?" Of course, Pookie said, "Yeah, man, I can make sure you get the highest score on that test." So Pookie went to school that entire week looking real spiffy, because his uniforms were ironed to perfection. The second week, Pookie decided that Barabi should carry all of his bags to school for a week. Barabi, of course, agreed because he simply wanted to pass his test. But Pookie, being the trickster that he was, found every book he could possibly find and placed all of them in his bags. You should have seen Barabi walking 2 miles to school, burdened and limping with what was the biggest and heaviest bag of books ever carried by any student in the world. When he finally arrived at school, he asked Pookie, "You better make sure I get an A on this test." Pookie looked at him in the eye and said, "You straight man, you could be the star of the class." On the third week before the test, Pookie decided that he was too tired to walk to school in the morning. So he instructed Barabi to carry him on his back every day to school for a week. Unbelievably, Barabi agreed because the only thing important to him was passing that test. So for an entire week, But Rabbi struggled and stumbled as he carried his friend to school down the road that seemed like it would never end. When they finally arrived, but Rabbi sweating and close to fainting, said,
"I did everything you wanted, and I need an A on that test tomorrow."
But Bucky, with full sincerity, said, "You gonna get the highest score in the whole town. Everyone gonna say how smart you is." The next day, it was time to take the test. But Rabbi made sure he sat right next to Babuki so he could see all of his answers. Every time Babuki wrote an answer, but Rabbi stared at his paper and wrote down the same answer. But Rabbi was smiling from ear to ear as he copied every letter, every word, and every sentence. When Barabi was finished, he jumped up, turned his paper into Miss Green, and bounced out of the class, confident that he had scored the best grade in the entire class and town. What he didn't see was that Babuki remained behind and erased all of his answers and replaced them with different answers. 2 days later, Miss Green came to class with the results of the test. But Rabbi sat to the front because he thought he would be praised as the student with the highest score. Miss Green called off everyone's grade aloud so that the entire class heard what everyone got. Charles, C+. Diane, B. Babuki, A. When Barabi heard this, he smiled because he knew he had copied everything from Babuki. Miss Green then said, "Barabi, F." Barabi, completely shocked, began to cry and shake with anger as he looked at Babuki, who had the biggest smile because he was crowned the smartest student in the class. The bell then rang, and Babuki quickly ran outside with Barabi chasing him close behind. The old people would say, "Every time a bell ring, you better remember that cheaters never prosper." If you shake my tree a little hard, another story might fall, but you might find out it ain't true at all.